Welcome. It's nice to have you here again this week. Knowing that you're out there somewhere, listening and watching with me. Very good. Are you comfortable? I hope so. Are you ready? Let's begin. I think maybe right now some of you bigger little people are thinking, oh no, here we go again. Tina's going to start talking about that box and saying all the stuff. We've heard it all before. But wait a minute. When Mum calls for the umpteenth time, tea is ready. Do you say, oh no, not another meal? Or when your birthday comes round again, do you say, oh no, not another birthday? You know, nothing is ever the same. So let's today listen and watch as though we've never listened and watched before. Shall we try that? Okay, I'll start now. Again. This box is gold. Gold is a very precious metal. So whatever's inside it must be precious. It's probably a parable. This box also looks a bit like a present. You know, parables are presents. They were given to us many, many years ago. They belong to us, even though we may not understand them. We may not know what they mean, but they are still given to us many years ago. They're also very old. Parables are older than your grandparents, older than anyone that I know, almost 2,000 years old. So it could well be that there's a parable. This box also has a lid, doesn't it? Parables sort of have lids. You know, they're sometimes quite hard to get into. But we keep on coming back, don't we, over and over. And one day, the parable will open for us. That, I think, is all I can say about this. So let's open it. See, I've got you sitting round me here. Welcome. I'm not allowed to look in the box. Oh, what's this? Oh, it's very white, isn't it? Goodness me. Oh, a white circle, maybe it's a big moon. Big moon. What else could it be? It could be spilt milk. Spilt milk on the carpet. A very white flower, maybe. What else could it be? I can think about all kinds of ideas this could be. But it is very white. I'll look in the box to see if there's anything else to help us with this parable. Oh, look at this. Look at this. What is this? A brown path? A worm, maybe. A worm. Centipede. Just a brown long thing. I wonder what it could be. I wonder what it could be. Oh, look at that. I wonder if it joins together. It's like a fence. It's a paddock. Maybe it's a paddock. I'll put that there. A doorway, maybe. Oh, there's some more of these funny brown things. What are these funny brown things? I wonder what they could be. Windows. Windows to snow. Windows on snow, but they've got a hole there. Wonder what that is. Here's another one. Another of the same. Put it that way. Lot of windows looking out on snow. Here's another one. Ooh, that's not so big. It's the big one. Put that there. Another window. This one's a square. It looks more square, doesn't it? And it's got a smaller opening. Very strange. And here's another. Of abstract art. Right, now what else is in here to help us tell the story? What have we got here? Bed, I think. Bed. And that looks nice and warm. Jug or a ewer for water. It's got a lot of stuff. Ooh, we've got another person here. This is his home. It's a bit small for him, but he's there. He's at a table. Now what's in here, I wonder?
so small, we're going to put it on there so you can see it.
That seems to be all the stuff that can get us ready for the parable. There was once someone who did such amazing things and said so many wonderful things that people just couldn't help it. They just had to follow him. And as they followed him, they heard him speaking about a kingdom. It wasn't like the kingdom they lived in, or like any kingdom they'd ever visited, or even like any kingdom they had ever heard of. They just couldn't help it. They just had to ask him, what is this kingdom like? What is the kingdom? Once, when they asked him, he said, the kingdom of heaven is like when a man who buys and sells pearls, a merchant, goes in search of the great. And this man who found the great pearl,
exchanges it for all that he has. I wonder if the merchant has a name. I wonder if he's happy with the great pearl. I wonder if he's happy that he found the great pearl. I wonder what the great pearl really is. I wonder if the seller has a name. I wonder if he's happy with all the new things he has. I wonder what he's going to do with them all. I wonder what the merchant's going to do next. And I wonder what the great pearl really is, and if we've ever, any of us, come close to the great pearl. And I wonder what can be so precious that someone would give all that they have in exchange for it. I wonder where this really is. Thanks for listening. It's an interesting parable. I really look forward to seeing what kind of artwork it inspires in you people who are watching this. Really look forward to seeing that. Again, thanks for listening, and look after yourselves and be good, and I'll see you next time. Bye.